Hi, this is Nanigal Salam, working as an assistant professor in the Department of Chemistry at Maratha Vidya Prasad Samaj Arts, Commerce and Science College, Bengaluru. In this video lecture, we will discuss about the molecular orbital energy level diagrams for O2 molecules, O2 minus ion molecules, O2 2 minus ion molecules and O2 plus molecule. Let us see one by one. First of all, we see the O2 molecular orbital energy level diagram. Basically, O2 molecule is formed by the combination of two oxygen atoms together. To understand how this O2 molecule is formed, we have to first of all understand the electronic configuration of each combining atom during the formation of molecule. The electronic configuration for the oxygen atom is 1s2, 2s2, and 2p4. Similarly, for second oxygen atom is 1s2, 2s2, and 2p4. Write this electronic configuration in the tabulated form for both oxygen atoms like this. Now, let us start the actual drawing of molecular orbital energy level diagram. For writing the molecular orbital energy level diagram, we have to write the valence shell atomic orbitals of each atom in the increasing order of energy from lower to the highest. On the left hand side, we write the 2s atomic orbital of one oxygen atom at the lower energy and 2p atomic orbital of same oxygen atom at the higher energy. Similarly, we write on the right hand side the atomic orbital of second oxygen atom at higher energy, 2p orbital of second oxygen atom. The energy of both 2p orbitals and 2s atomic orbitals of both oxygen atoms is same. Now, when these 2s atomic orbitals and these 2p atomic orbitals of both oxygen atoms combine together, they form the molecular orbital. There is 8 atomic orbitals from both oxygen atoms combine together and forms the 8 molecular orbital. Out of this 8 molecular orbital, 4 are bonding molecular orbital and 4 are anti-bonding molecular orbital. When 2s atomic orbital of both oxygen atoms combines together, they form the 2 molecular orbital. Out of these 2 molecular orbital, the one is lower energy bonding molecular orbital and second one is higher energy anti-bonding molecular orbital. Basically, bonding molecular orbital is denoted by using the symbol sigma 2s and anti-bonding molecular orbital is denoted by using the symbol sigma star 2s. Similarly, when 2p atomic orbitals of both oxygen combine together, they form a 6 molecular orbital. Out of this 6 molecular orbital, 3 molecular orbital is bonding molecular orbital and which is lower in energy with respect to the energy of atomic orbitals of combining atoms. And higher energy orbital is called as antibonding molecular orbital, which is higher in energy than that of atomic orbitals of oxygen atoms. When 2p atomic orbital combines, they produce the lowest energy sigma bonding molecular orbital and is denoted by using the symbol sigma 2px. Similarly, they form the pi molecular orbital and it denoted by using the symbol pi 2py and pi 2pz. The antibonding orbital, which is formed by the combination of 2p atomic orbitals of oxygen, is denoted by using the symbol pi star 2py and pi star 2pz. Similarly, highest energy sigma antibonding molecular orbital is denoted by using the symbol sigma star 2px. The next important point is filling of electron in the molecular orbital in increasing order of energy from atomic orbitals of both oxygen atoms. Basically, electron is filled in the molecular orbital according to the above principle and Hund's rule of maximum multiplicity. There are 12 electrons which is available in the atomic orbitals of both oxygen atoms, and we have to fill this 12 electrons one by one in the molecular orbital with the increasing order of energy. The first electron comes to the sigma bonding molecular orbital. After that, third and fourth electron goes to the sigma star antibonding molecular orbital like this. The fifth and sixth electron comes to the sigma 2px bonding molecular orbital one by one. Seventh and eighth electron comes to the pi 2py and pi 2pz molecular orbital separately, because these two molecular orbitals are degenerative energy levels, and that's why according to the Hund's rule of maximum multiplicity, there is no pairing of electron in any one of the molecular orbital if each molecular orbital having at least one electron in it, and that's why these two electrons get unpaired in the two molecular orbital. The next 9th and 10th electron comes to the pi 2py and pi 2pz molecular orbital and get paired in the pi 2py and pi 2pz molecular orbital. The remaining two electrons goes to the pi star 2py and pi star 2pz antibonding molecular orbital. There is no pairing of electron in any one of the molecular orbital. The next important point is writing the electronic configuration for the molecular orbital with the increasing order of energy one by one. On the basis of this molecular orbital diagram, we can easily write the electronic configuration for the molecular orbital. Let us start to write the electronic configuration for the molecular orbital energy level diagram. Basically, we have to write, first of all, this K in the writing the electronic configuration, because one s electron of both oxygen atom does not take part in the bonding, and that's why the electronic configuration is KK sigma 2s to 2 sigma star 2s to 2 sigma 2px to 2 pi 2py s to 2 pi 2pz s to 2, and this two molecular orbital is degenerated, that's why denoted by the equal sign. Next, pi star 2py s to 1 equivalent with the energy pi star 2pz s to 1. There is one electron in the antibonding orbital of O2 molecule. The next important point is calculation of energy evolved during the formation of O2 molecule. Basically, energy is calculated by using the formula number of electrons in the bonding molecular orbital into minus beta plus number of electrons in antibonding molecular orbital into plus beta. Here, we have 8 electrons in the bonding molecular orbital and 4 electrons in the antibonding molecular orbital. And put this value in the formula, we get the equation of 8 into minus beta plus 4 into plus beta. After putting this value and solve this equation, we get the value of minus 4 beta as a stabilization energy. That means there is evolution of energy during the formation of O2 molecule. The next important point is calculation of bond order. Basically, bond order is calculated by using the formula number of electrons in bonding molecular orbital minus number of electrons in the antibonding molecular orbital divided by 2. After putting the values of number of electrons in BMO and ABMO, we get the values of 2. That means there is formation of two bonds between the two oxygen atoms for the formation of O2 molecule. The next important point is stability. On the basis of energy wall and bond order, we are comes to the conclusion of the O2 molecule is stable one and it found in the gas system. The next important point is magnetic property of O2 molecule. This is the very important point for the differentiation between the VBT and MOD. Basically, there is two electrons which is unpaired in the pi star antibonding molecular orbital of an O2 molecule, and which is responsible for O2 molecule is paramagnetic in nature, and the magnetic moment is 2.84 Bohr's magneton experimentally. This nature of paramagnetism is not explained by the VBT, and that's why VBT is failed for the explanation of magnetic property of O2 molecule. But the magnetic property of O2 molecule is easily explained by using the MOT, that is molecular orbital energy level diagram, and that's why MOT is superior than that of VBT. The next molecular orbital diagram is O2 minus molecular orbital energy level diagram. This molecular orbital energy level diagram or molecule is formed by the combination of one oxygen atom and one O minus ion. Electronic configuration for the oxygen is 1s2, 2s2, 2 and 2p4. Similarly, the electronic configuration for O minus ion is 1s2, 2s2, 2 and 2p5. There is one electron extra in the oxygen atom than that of first one, but it accepts the one electron extra than that of its basic electronic configuration. Write this electronic configuration in the tabulated form for the oxygen as well as oxygen ion. For oxygen, 2s2, 2 and 2p4. Similarly, for O minus 2s2, 2 and 2p5. This blue color electron is extra electron which is added in the valence shell of an oxygen atom. Let us write the molecular orbital diagram. For writing the molecular orbital energy level diagram, we have to write the valence shell atomic orbital in increasing order of energy one by one. On the left hand side, we write the atomic orbital of oxygen atom. On the right hand side, we write the atomic orbital of O minus ion. First of all, we write the 2s atomic orbital of oxygen at the lower energy side and 2p atomic orbital of oxygen at the higher energy side on the left hand side. On the right hand side, we write the 2s atomic orbital at the lower energy side for the O minus ion and at the higher energy side 2p atomic orbital of an O minus ion. When this 8 atomic orbital combines together, it produces an 8 molecular orbital. Out of this 8 molecular orbital, the 4 is bonding molecular orbital and 4 is antibonding molecular orbital. When 2s atomic orbital combines together, they form the lowest energy bonding molecular orbital and is denoted by using the symbol sigma 2s, and higher energy antibonding molecular orbital is denoted by using the symbol sigma star 2s. Similarly, when 2p atomic orbitals of both oxygen as well as O minus ion combines together, they produce the bonding molecular orbital, which is denoted by the sigma 2px, and pi bonding molecular orbital, which is denoted by pi 2py and pi 2pz respectively, which is degenerating energy level. An antibonding molecular orbital is denoted by using the symbol pi star 2py and pi star 2pz respectively. And higher energy antibonding molecular orbital is denoted by using the symbol sigma star 2px. The next important point is filling of electron in the molecular orbital with the increasing order of energy from lowest energy towards the higher energy. There is total 13 electron which is available from the oxygen atom and O minus ion. Basically, there is one extra electron than that of O2 molecular orbital energy level diagram in the O2 minus MO diagram. And that's why we have to fill this electron in the increasing order of energy one by one. First two electron comes to the sigma 2s bonding molecular orbital one by one. Similarly, third and fourth electron goes to the sigma star 2s antibonding molecular orbital, which is produced by the combination of 2s atomic orbitals of both oxygen as well as O minus ion. Fifth and sixth electron comes to the sigma 2px bonding molecular orbital one by one and get completely filled. Eighth and ninth electron comes to the pi 2py and pi 2pz bonding molecular orbital separately. This two electron does not get paired in the any one of the pi bonding molecular orbital according to the Hund-Sholl maximum multiplicity. The next 9th and 10th electron comes to the pi 2py and pi 2pz bonding molecular orbital and get paired at the lower energy. The next electron goes to the pi star 2py and pi star 2pz antibonding molecular orbital and get filled symmetrically. And the remaining last one electron goes to the pi star 2py antibonding molecular orbital and get paired here now. There is only one electron which is unpaired in nature at the pi star 2py molecular orbital in the O2 minus molecular orbital energy level diagram. Now, the next important point is writing the electronic configuration of a molecular orbital in the increasing order of energy one by one. First of all, we have to write the twist k for the 1s shell of both oxygen atoms. And the electronic configuration is kk sigma 2s to 2 sigma star 2s to 2 sigma 2px to 2 pi 2py to 2 is degenerate with the pi 2pz to 2. Pi star 2py to 2 is degenerate with the pi star 2pz to 1. There is only difference in the O2 and O2 minus molecular orbital diagram is there is extra electron in the O2 minus molecular orbital energy level diagram, which is responsible for change the other properties like as energy or bond order as well as the magnetic property of an O2 minus ion molecule from O2 molecule. The next important point is energy hole. Basically, energy hole is calculated by using the formula number of electron in bonding molecular orbital into minus beta plus number of electron in antibonding molecular orbital into plus beta. Put this value of number of electron in BMO and ABMO in the formula, we get the equation of 8 into minus beta plus 5 into plus beta. After solving this, we get the values of minus 3 beta as a stabilization energy. This energy is lesser than that of O2 molecule that we see in the next. The next important point is calculation of bond order. Basically, bond order is calculated by using the formula number of electron in bonding molecular orbital minus number of electron in antibonding molecular orbital divided by 2. Put this value of number of electron in BMO and ABMO, we get the equation of 8 minus 5 divided by 2. And after solving it, we get the values of 1.5. That means there is formation of 1.5 bond between the two oxygen atoms. The next important point is stability. This molecule is formed easily because there is evolution of energy during the formation of O2 minus ion molecule as well as there is 1.5 bond order between the two combining oxygen atoms. The next important point is magnetic property for O2 minus ion molecule. Basically, this molecule is paramagnetic in nature like the O2 molecule, but the experimental value of paramagnetism is 1.84 Bose magnetons only. This is the major difference between the molecular orbital diagram of O2 and O2 minus ion. The next molecular orbital energy level diagram is O2 2 minus ion molecular orbital energy level diagram. Basically, O2 2 minus ion molecule is formed by the combination of two O minus ion together. Let us say the electronic configuration for the H O minus ion. The electronic configuration for the O minus is 1s2p, 2s2p, and 2p5. There is one extra electron in the valence shell of an oxygen atom than that of oxygen atom. The second atom electronic configuration is 1s2, 2s2, 2, and 2p5. When these two O minus ion comes together and forms the bond, it gives an O2 2 minus molecular ions. Let us write this valence shell electronic configuration for the both oxygen ions in the tabulated form like this, 2s2, 2 and 2p5. There is one extra electron than that of oxygen atom in the O minus ion. Similarly, for the second O minus ion is 2s2, 2, 2p5. Let us start the actual drawing of molecular orbital energy level diagram for the O2 2 minus ion. We have to write, first of all, the increasing order of energy of an valence shell atomic orbital one by one. On the left hand side, we write the one oxygen ion atomic orbitals one by one. At the lower energy, 2s atomic orbital and higher energy 2p atomic orbitals. Similarly, for second oxygen atom, at the lower energy, 2s atomic orbital and higher energy 2p atomic orbital. When these 8 atomic orbitals combine together according to the linear combination of atomic orbitals, they produce an 8 molecular orbital. Out of this 8 molecular orbital, 4 are bonding molecular orbital and 4 are antibonding molecular orbital. When 2s atomic orbital of both O minus ion or oxygen ion combines together, they produce the lowest energy bonding molecular orbital and it is denoted by using the symbol sigma 2s. Similarly, the antibonding molecular orbital is denoted by using the symbol sigma star 2s. When 2p atomic orbital of both oxygen ion combines together, they form the lower energy bonding molecular orbital and it is denoted by sigma 2px and pi 2py and pi 2pz respectively. This 2 pi 2py and pi 2pz molecular orbital is degenerate in energy and higher in energy than that of sigma 2px molecular orbital. Similarly, the antibonding molecular orbital is denoted by using the symbol pi star 2py and pi star 2pz respectively. This 2 molecular orbital is degenerate in energy and the highest energy antibonding molecular orbital, that is sigma antibonding molecular orbital, is denoted by the symbol sigma star 2px. The next important point is filling of electron from the both oxygen ions into the molecular orbital in the increasing order of energy one by one. The filling of electron is take place according to the above principle and Hund's rule of maximum multiplicity. First electron comes to the lowest energy unoccupied molecular orbital, that is sigma 2s bonding molecular orbital, one by one. The next two electrons comes to the sigma star 2s antibonding molecular orbital one by one and it gets completely filled. The third and fourth electron comes to the sigma 2px bonding molecular orbital one by one. Seventh and eighth electron comes to the pi 2py and pi 2pz bonding molecular orbital one by one at the degenerate energy level. And these two electrons not get paired in the any one of the molecular orbital according to the Hund's rule of maximum multiplicity. The next two electron comes to the pi 2py and pi 2pz bonding molecular orbital one by one and get completely filled. After complete filling of these two pi 2py and pi 2pz bonding molecular orbital, the next electron goes to the antibonding molecular orbital, that is pi star 2py and pi star 2pz one by one. The next two remaining electron comes to the pi star 2py and pi star 2pz antibonding molecular orbital one by one and there is complete filling of electron is take place. After complete filling of electron, we are comes to the conclusion of there is no unpaired electron in the molecular orbitals of an O2 2 minus ion. This is very important for the magnetic property. The next important point is writing the electronic configuration of a molecular orbital in the increasing order of energy one by one. First of all, we have to write the 2sk for the Kornis atomic orbitals, which is not take part in the bonding for the O2 2 minus ion formation. That's why the electron configuration is AK sigma 2s to 2 sigma star 2s to 2 sigma 2px to 2 pi 2py s to 2 is degenerate with the pi 2pz 2. The next pi star 2py to 2 pi star 2pz to 2 is degenerate with each other. The next important point is energy wall during the formation of O2 2 minus ion. Basically, energy wall is calculated by using the formula the number of electrons in the bonding molecular orbital into minus beta plus the number of electron in antibonding molecular orbital into plus beta. After putting the value of number of electron in BMO and ABMO, we get the equation 8 into minus beta plus 6 into plus beta. After solving this, we get the values of minus 2 beta as a stabilization energy. This is the energy which is involved during the formation of O2 minus ion molecule. The next important point is calculation of bond order. Basically, bond order is calculated by using the formula number of electron in bonding molecular orbital minus number of electron in antibonding molecular orbital divided by 2. After putting the value of number of electron in bonding molecular orbital and antibonding molecular orbital and solving the equation, we get the values of 1. That means there is formation of one bond between the two oxygen ions. The next important point is stability. As we know that there is evolution of energy and the bond order is 1, the molecule is formed easily. The next important point is magnetic property. Basically, magnetic property is based on the number of unpaired electrons in the molecule. There is no unpaired electron in the molecule, that is, all the electrons are paired in the molecule, and that's why the O2 minus ion molecule is diamagnetic. The next important molecular orbital diagram is O2 plus molecular orbital energy level diagram. Basically, O2 plus ion molecule is formed by the combination of one oxygen atom and one oxygen positive atom, that is O plus atom, together. To understand how this O2 plus ion molecule is formed, we have to first of all understand the electronic configuration for the each combining oxygen atom. The electronic configuration for the oxygen atom is 1s2, 2s2, 2n2, 2p4. Similarly, the electronic configuration for the O2 plus ion is 1s2, 2s2, 2, and 2p3. There is one less electron than that of normal oxygen atom. Write this valential electronic configuration in the tabulated form like this. For oxygen, 2s2, 2 and 2p4. Similarly, for O plus ion, 2s2, 2 and 2p3. Let us start the actual drawing of molecular orbital energy level diagram. For molecular orbital energy level diagram, we have to write the valence shell atomic orbital in increasing order of energy, 1 by 1. On the left hand side, we write the atomic orbital of oxygen, 1 by 1. The 2s at lower energy and 2p at higher energy. Similarly, for the oxygen plus ion at the right hand side, 2s at the lower energy and 2p at higher energy, like this, and the number of electrons in it, respectively. When these 8 atomic orbitals combine together, they form the 8 molecular orbital. Out of these 8 molecular orbitals, 4 are bonding molecular orbital and 4 are antibonding molecular orbital. When 2s atomic orbital combines together, they form the lower energy bonding molecular orbital and is denoted by the symbol sigma 2s. Similarly, higher energy sigma star 2s. When 2p atomic orbital combines together, they form the bonding molecular orbital and is denoted by the symbol sigma 2px and pi 2py and pi 2pz for the bonding molecular orbital and pi star 2py and pi star 2pz sigma star 2px for the antibonding molecular orbitals. Next important point is filling of electron from the oxygen and oxygen ion, oxygen plus ion from the atomic orbital into the molecular orbital. Basically, there are 11 electrons in the atomic orbital of oxygen and oxygen positive ion. We have to fill this 11 electron one by one in the molecular orbital. First electron comes to the lowest energy and occupies sigma 2s bonding molecular orbital one by one. After that, third and fourth electron comes to the sigma star 2s antibonding molecular orbital one by one. Fifth and sixth electron comes to the lowest unoccupied sigma 2px bonding molecular orbital one by one. Seventh and eighth electron comes to the pi 2py and pi 2pz bonding molecular orbital one by one. And get half filled pi 2py and pi 2pz molecular orbitals. There is no pairing of two electrons in any one of the pi molecular orbital according to the Hertzsprung law of maximum multiplicity. The next two electron also comes to the pi 2py and pi 2pz bonding molecular orbital one by one. And last one remaining electron goes to the pi star 2py or pi star 2pz antibonding molecular orbital. This is all about the filling of electron in the bonding molecular orbital and antibonding molecular orbital of O2 plus molecular orbitals. On the basis of this molecular orbital energy level diagram, we come to the conclusion of writing the electronic configuration for the molecular orbital with the increasing order of energy one by one. First of all, we have to write Fis K for the 1s shell which is does not take part in the bonding. And the electronic configuration is KK sigma 2s2 2 sigma star 2s2 2 sigma 2px s2 2 pi 2py s2 2 is generated with pi 2pz s2 2 pi star 2py s2 1 is generated with pi 2pz s2 0. We write here pi star to pi z 0 intentionally because for O2 molecule there is one electron, but for O2 plus there is no electron in pi star to pi z molecule of orbital. This is the major difference between the O2 and O2 plus ion molecular orbital energy level diagram. The next important point is energy mode. Basically, energy well is calculated by using the formula number of electron in bonding molecular orbital into minus beta plus number of electron in antibonding molecular orbital into plus beta. After putting the value, we get the equation of 8 into minus beta plus 3 into plus beta. After solving this, we get the value of minus 5 beta as a stabilization energy. The next important point is calculation of bond order. Basically, bond order is calculated by using the formula number of electron in bonding molecular orbital minus number of electron in antibonding molecular orbital divided by 2. After solving this, we get the value of 2.5. That means there is formation of 2.5 bond between the two oxygen atoms of an O2 plus ion molecule. The next important point is stability. This molecule is formed according to the bond order as well as energy concept. Next important point is magnetic property. Basically, there is only one electron which is unpaired in nature in the pi star to py molecular orbital, and that's why this O2 plus ion is paramagnetic in nature. And the experimental value of paramagnetism is 1.84 Bohr's magneton. This is all about the molecular orbital energy level diagram for O2 plus ion molecule. The next important point is comparison between the O2, O2 minus, O2 2 minus and O2 plus molecular orbital energy level diagram. Let us see one by one. Basically, oxygen molecule having energy wall is minus 4 beta. When one electron is added into the antibonding molecular orbital, the energy evolution is lowered by the 1 beta. Similarly, when 2 electron is added in the O2 molecule, we get the stabilization energy of minus 2 beta as a result. But when one electron is removed from the antibonding molecular orbital, we get the stabilization energy as a minus 5 beta. Similarly, we look into the bond order. The bond order for the O2 molecule is 2.0, but when we add the electron in antibonding molecular orbital, bond order goes on decreasing. Similarly, we add the another extra electron, the bond order is 1.0. That means after addition of electron in the antibonding molecular orbital, the bond order is decreases by 0.5. But when we remove the electron from the antibonding molecular orbital, the bond order goes on increasing, that is 2.5. That means for O2 molecule, then the bond order is 2.0, for O2 minus 1.5 and O2 2 minus 1.0. But for O2 plus, the bond order is 2.5. Similarly, for the bond length, between the two oxygen atoms is 1.21 angstrom. But when we add the electron into the antibonding molecular orbital, the bond length goes on increasing. Similarly, for O2 2 minus, bond length is increasing. But when we remove the electron from antibonding molecular orbital, that time the bond order is increases as well as bond length is decreases. That means there is inverse relation between the bond order and bond length. And the magnetic property is only O2 2 minus is diamagnetic in nature, and all three oxygen ion as well as oxygen molecule is paramagnetic in nature. We have to keep in mind here the bond order and bond length are inversely proportional to each other. Thank you for watching.